This dress is sticking to me. I don't know what's going on. Also, I am wondering if geishas wear leggings, but I guess they do now. Just a tiny little bit more. I'm already tired and I did not even make the video yet.
Hello?
It happens to me often that I lose my microphone and I am not aware of it.
No.
This microphone does not want to be Japanese. I have been doing pretty much nothing all week. Last week I did something. I created a real life mood board for you guys because I want to make a video called Unique Antique. And instead of me just sitting here holding things up, showing you things and talking about it, I thought maybe it is nice to try something a little bit different. And yeah, that was about it. That was my whole idea behind it. Did not do a lot of thinking. I transformed this whole corner in my house into a little bit of a vintage antique curiosity / other things I bought because maybe I'm turning into some sort of a shopaholic situation, and I want to take you guys along around to check out all the things that I bought, things that I'm going to use in my living room makeover. And yeah, so welcome to the Unique Antique video. Before we go into all the decor things that I bought, I think maybe we should talk about furniture first, because there is a very big elephant that is not in this room right now. And with elephant, I am talking about my cabinet of curiosities that was supposed to be here, and it is not. The whole reason why I bought all of these things and the whole reason why I decided to make a Unique Antique video was because of the cabinet of curiosities. And I do not know if you have seen my tiny little hallway makeover. Probably not, because almost nobody watched those videos. There was one thing I learned about myself when I did the tiny makeover. I learned that I do not like a huge quantity of small things in a very confined space. Now, what is a cabinet of curiosities? I will give you a few seconds to think about it. I had a little bit of an issue and I decided to do a little experiment. I gathered all of the things that I bought and I decorated the living shit out of my cabinet of curiosities. And when I was finished, I was feeling very, very disappointed. First of all, every single decor item I bought was inside that cabinet. There was nothing left for the rest of my living room. Everything was empty, except of course for all of my houseplants. And also, when I was standing straight in front of the cabinet, I could kind of see what was in it. But as soon as I did one step to the side, and let me show you what happened. What do you see? Nothing. Right. Now I have all of these pretty things inside of a very beautiful cabinet, but am I going to enjoy it? Probably not. So I decided the best way to go for me is to turn my whole living room in a cabinet of curiosities. And then there is another elephant that is in this room. And it is next to me, and you already saw it when I was talking to you before. It is the cabinet. The cabinet that I used in the tiny little hallway makeover. I decided that I love this cabinet so much. I want to have it around. I want to be able to see it, not for 2 seconds when I walk in and out of my house, but all of the time. It is just me, you know. I'm an ever-changing person. I am... I wonder where all of this will end. And I sure hope that it will end well. I'm so happy though that I can talk to you guys about all of my elephants. So it is the next day, a more casual day. I decided to wait for one more piece of art. It got delivered this morning. It is something that I really want to show you. For the last 2 weeks, I did a lot of thinking about all of this decor because I ordered a lot of things that I really like. But what I do not want is to create a very old-fashioned space. So I am on the lookout for things that are a little bit more modern or a little bit more retro or a little bit more artistic. Instead of just buying a whole bunch of very old things. And this print that I ordered online really helps out a lot. So I changed up a few things. Everything in here is still not in the place where it is going to be, because like I told you, this is just a mood board I created. So I think I'm going to start with a piece of art that came this morning. We really need to talk about the lady over there with the crazy hair. Also because she had a little accident in the mill and she is looking pretty rough. This is the print that arrived this morning. It is a textile design made by William Morris. He died in 1998 and he was the founder of the British art and craft movement. He made a lot of very beautiful designs and you can buy them online. Most of the prints that you can find online only have his name and a little bit of text underneath, but I decided that I liked this one with a little bit of additional information. These prints are not very cheap, but they are quite affordable. I think I paid 36 euros for this one. The only thing right now that I do not like, of course, is this frame. This is a very, very cheap IKEA frame. And what I would like to do is make some trim myself. And I want to glue it on the frame. And then I want to paint the whole thing. And I think then it is going to look a lot nicer. I have a lot of these frames in all kinds of different sizes. And if this works out, it would help me out a lot because I am planning to start collecting more art and I could really use these frames. And right now I think they are not the most prettiest frames and also very, very boring. It is nice to have something a little bit substantial hanging above this cabinet instead of an itty bitty tiny little thing like these plates over here, because my first initial plan was to hang these two plates above this cabinet, but I like this a lot more. And these plates I think are very beautiful. They are very old, and what I like about it is that they are also very big, because a lot of the times plates that you can hang on your wall are just a little bit too small. I was looking for something a little bit different to hang on my walls instead of only using prints and arts like this painting, for example, over here. I think this is a lovely, lovely painting. It is called The Blue Cloak and it is made by a painter called Isaac Michael Cohen. He was born in Australia, but he won a scholarship and he went to Paris and he was very successful. After that, he also lived in London for many, many years. He won a lot of prizes. He painted a lot of very beautiful ladies and some gentlemen too. The nice thing about this print is that it was made in Amsterdam in 1930. So it is quite old. She has the most beautiful face. And I also think that this painting has a little bit of a vintage feel. The blue cloak is also so beautiful. And I don't know if you have noticed already, but I am going with a little bit of a blue theme, and strangely also a lot of orange sneaked up into my whole design plan, and this was not something that I planned for. It was just something that happened, so that's interesting. And then we have this very interesting lady over here. And I do not know if she had an issue with the mailman or the mailman had an issue with her. But as you can see, she arrived broken. And I already did a little bit of fixing because I was so sad about it. I bought this on a marketplace from a lady. She made this herself. Her inspiration was an artist called Melanie Bourget. I'm not sure if I'm pronouncing that correctly. I will put a link to the website of this artist in my description. She has some very interesting art. I think it is so nice to have something so original. I love the colors. And yeah, I bought a piece of art and I ended up with a project. This whole part of her hair was broken. And the strange thing was that not all of the pieces were there. I have no idea how that's possible, but I glued in the bigger pieces. I still have a few pieces over here, very small ones, and they are just falling apart. But even with these pieces over here, I was left with a very big hole in her head, hair. So what I did was I mixed up some plaster because I do not have any clay. I tried to get as much of the plaster inside of this part of her head because this whole statue is hollow on the inside. And from there I decided to build it up a little bit. I recreated the shape. I do think that it looks okay. It is still pretty rough, and as you can see, it is also still drying. And what I am planning to do when this is dry, I'm going to turn her around very carefully. And I'm going to pour plaster into the entire statue. And in that way, I really hope that she is not going to have a breakdown anymore. I also had a little bit of a problem because, of course, I need to paint this. So I asked the lady on Marketplace about her paint colors and she gave me the information. I ordered the paint, so it is going to be interesting. Probably I have to put a little bit of the paint in different areas to make it blend in. But I am very hopeful that I can make this very interesting lady all nice again. Over here I have a wooden box with a very interesting content. But first I want to talk about this little corner over here. This piece of furniture is something that I found in the trash. It was in my plant room before, but I had another little plant stand that I could use in that room, and I really like this one. I was so happy when I found it. Of course I gave it a paint job, but it is one of my favorite pieces of furniture. I love the shape and I also love these wooden spindles. Underneath here I just gathered a few things. This you already saw in my tiny hallway makeover, but it got replaced with mushrooms. And I still think that it is very pretty, so right now it is over here. This was a handle that I also showed you, a handle from a coal bucket. And I decided to put it in this, I'm not sure how you call this. Is this a cloche? I need to look it up. But anyway, you can see what I'm talking about. And by putting it in this little thing over here, it changed from a handle into a little bit of a piece of art, or at least that was my idea behind it. And I don't know, I like it. This is just a very vintagey retro cup. I think it would be nice to put a little plant in here, but for now it is over here. This is just to give you a little bit of an impression, a little bit of a gathering of some things together. On top of this piece of furniture, I have this beautiful wooden box. I bought this at a flea market. It was not for sale. The man who was selling things used this to display some things that he was selling, and I asked him, can I please buy this wooden box? And he said yes. I bought this for €4, I believe. It also has a little metal detail on the top. And I'm not completely sure where this is from. I do not have the key though. But maybe one day I will find myself a tiny little key. And on top of this wooden box I have a little collection of very old glass bottles from a pharmacy. And I love little things like this. I think they are so beautiful. They are actually very expensive. And I had to look very long and very hard to find myself a few bottles that I could actually afford. I have a few more. These are just a little part of the collection that I bought. I also decided to buy myself a few tins. I bought a few tins for the blue and white farmhouse bedroom makeover, and I really liked them, and I decided I wanted a few for myself. This is a candle holder. I'm not completely sure how it is going to look with a candle in it. I do not think that blue glass is very cozy, but I guess we have to try it out. But I really like the shape of this, and I really like the blue color of the glass, and I think it is a nice little collection of vintage things. I also have this beautiful spider plant over here, and my plan is to hang it from the ceiling somewhere over there to fill up this little bit of a white, boring, empty space. So this will go over there. I think it is going to be very nice to have a little bit more greenery. Maybe I will also hang it a little bit lower, about here. I am planning to keep this painting over here. I do think that I need to lower it just a little bit. Right now it is just a little bit too high. This is something that I'm going to tell you about later, because this is one of the things that is inside that wooden box that I just showed you. I have a few more of these beautiful glass bottles. And another one of those tins. This is a sketch from Leonardo da Vinci. It is something I found on the internet, and I just used my own printer to make this. This little frame was something that I already had, but I removed the color that it had because it was a very dark color of brown. It was very depressing. I have a huge amount of respect for Leonardo da Vinci. When I was in primary school, we had art history. And I was always fascinated by him. I always thought that he was very interesting artist. Next to her, I have a very old man. And I don't know why, but something about him, there's something about him that I really like. He reminds me of a grandfather that I would love to have. I think somebody to teach you about literature and the art of having patience, something that I do not master myself. I have a very big empty wall on the other side of my living room, and I would love to change that whole wall in a collage of all kinds of different art pieces and paintings, and I think maybe these things are a little bit of a start. There is something else that I would like to add, and I have it over here. This is the paper that was inside of the very old suitcase that I showed you in my tiny hallway makeover video. And when I saw the footage of that suitcase, I decided that I was not going to keep it. It was too far gone. I never used it. The only reason why I kept it for so many years was because of this paper. So I decided just to remove a part of the bottom of the suitcase. This was the part that looked the best. It still has a little bit of staining, but I do not really mind that. And I actually do not have that suitcase anymore. This frame was the frame that was around the little painting with the flowers. And I already told you that I really did not like the combination of the frame and the painting. So I decided to use this frame for this. And I'm going to keep my eyes open for a different frame for the flower painting. I also bought myself another blue and white teapot. Do I already have a few blue and white teapots? Yes. Do I need another teapot? No. Do I drink tea? No. But none of my other teapots come with this little thing. I am not going to use this as a teapot. I am going to use it as a very big essential oil burner. You can buy burners, but they are always very small, and most of the time they are also very boring and very ugly. And I thought, you know, I better go big or go home. And this is just very nice. I can put
some warm water in here with some essential oils. I can put a tea light in here that burns for, I don't know, 8 hours. And then my house is going to smell so lovely for a long, long time.
I do think that it is very beautiful. I also really like the birds. I think I am going to use this a lot. I paid 10 euros for this. I also found this on Marketplace.
I just looked around me and then I realized that there were a few things that I actually forgot to put into this real life mood board. Things I also bought. When I'm going to add these things, there are just going to be so many interesting things to show you and also so many interesting stories that I want to tell you. I want to take my time. I do not want to rush anything. So I decided the best thing to do is to make it into a two-part series. Part 2 will be online next week on Sunday. I really hope you enjoyed watching this video. If you did, please consider subscribing to my channel. And I really hope to see you next week in part 2 of Unique Antique. Bye!